question. Oh, well, she says, now it's also said that we initially come from that higher state and our task is to return there. My question is, why on earth should I want to reach that state if I can fall out of it again and again? I would prefer some state that's more stable. I've asked many scholars, gurus, but I haven't got a satisfying answer from any of them so far. I very much appreciate your reply.
We don't fall from the state of God consciousness. We dive. We jump out of the airplane without a parachute. Because it seemed like a good idea at the time. You know, it's like that story of the guy who jumps from the top of the skyscraper, and as he's going down the 15th floor, 10th, 9th, somebody calls out, "How are you?" "So far, so good," you know. Well, okay, we're kind of in that. But the point is, it was a choice. It wasn't something that we were forced to do. We fell into ego consciousness because we wanted the intensity of sensory experience. We wanted to know existence within the dream and all of the kinds of experiences that you can't have in God consciousness, like suffering. And so since God has limitations, because God can't suffer and can't know what it is to have a gender. God is not male or female, and God is not able to have experiences of giving birth and of dying and of fighting in wars and duels and all of those kinds of military enjoyments that some people are into, or other kinds of competitive activities, maybe like basketball or soccer or other games, or chess or whatever. People, the consciousness enjoys being a people and being involved in all kinds of ways of using intelligence for basically vain and futile purposes, for the enjoyment of testing oneself within a playing field that isn't available in heaven. And so it was a choice to come down, and it was a choice to go through all the permutations of consciousness from soul down to ego, and ego in its let's say, most degraded form at the end, in order to learn from all of those experiences and gain the wisdom that would enable us now to make the choice to get back in that, I won't say airplane, spaceship perhaps, into that supreme consciousness from which we came, and this time to say, okay, I've had enough. And remain as that eternal light rather than blowing our own light out in order to know darkness. So it is an experience that gives an awesome kind of beauty and revelation of the shadow side of life, the dark night of the soul, literally, and to know the beauty of the darkness as well as the infinite beauty of the light. And by doing that, we become whole. We become true beings that contain the non-duality of day and night, of time and eternity, life and death, of all the paradoxes that reality could provide. And we become the embodiment of that paradox. And it is that ultimate capacity to vibrate again with simultaneously the realization that you are nothingness, absolute nothingness, at the same time that you seem to exist as a being in a world with some kind of positive energy, and the infinite oscillation at the speed of divine light breaks you through the illusion of the phenomenal plane and makes you realize that we never fell at all. This was never anything but a hologram that is the divine light in drag, but we have never left that supreme abode of ultimate absolute bliss. And this is the way that we decided to enjoy that bliss and spend some of our eternity within the illusory realm of time, just because God can do anything God wants to do. And now we want to bring the light and the peace and the love and the silence back once again to heal the world that we have created as an illusion to entertain ourself in this beautiful tapestry that is the great work of art that God calls creation.